things that we are seeing today in the world that we are living in. Because many of us are not actually looking out for signs anymore. We are just doing the way we like. We are just, we have worshiped God in a way that we have established for ourselves. It doesn't matter to us what God wants in our praise. What God wants in our worship, we give Him. It's like you give somebody that is hungry food and say, take this food. If you like, you don't eat it, you don't know. But I'll still come and tell you that this is what you will do for me. That's rebellion. The height of rebellion. It's in this time that we are having this strange ministry of the spirit of Elijah. It's still the same spirit that operated inside Noah, warned people that see destruction is coming. It's still the same spirit that operated in John the Baptist, came in the spirit of Elijah to end a dispensation and start another dispensation. It's still the same spirit that we're expecting in the church today, the spirit of Elijah. What is he coming to do? He's coming to tell people that the age of grace, even at the age of grace, people are talking about hyper grace. That means grace is even coming to, they have deformed the grace, and they are telling us that the grace cannot allow us to do anything. The grace is coming to an end. We are in the genre of the grace. We're in the genre. I can tell you categorically clear that we might have entered the last 7 years of the world the way we know it. We might just have entered this eclipse. If God created the light bearers and kept them in heaven so that they will be as a sign to us to know what He's doing and what He's planning and what He's doing, His counsel and everything. If we can see eclipse happening, two dispensations are coming together, two constellations are coming together. Do you understand what I'm saying? We should be able to know that there's something we have to do. What we have to do, we cannot separate it from the ministry of angels. Angels, they are still there. They excel in strength to deliver on the counsel of God. God has set the angels there so that the angels will minister to the heirs of salvation. Who are the heirs of salvation? It's us. Everything that God wanted to do, God required the ministry of the angels. When He wanted to communicate Isaac, He sent an angel. Do you remember? Abraham identified the angel. He said, come, join me in my house and eat first. Don't leave. The angels. Jacob fought with an angel. His name changed. Jericho. Joshua and Jericho. There was an angel for Joshua. He had a sword with his arms drawn. Sword drawn in his arms. He went to ask, are you for us or are you against us? He said, I am come as the commander of the armies of the host of heaven. That was an angel. There were angels on many occasions. Many occasions angels have come. Remember Daniel, when he prayed for God to give him revelation, and the angel fought against the prince of Persia just for light. Daniel waited for light, just light. See, the ministry of angel even went into the ministry of Jesus. The birth of Jesus wasn't without an angel. Mary, you are blessed and highly favored. He said, the spirit of the highest shall overshadow you, and he will leave in you a seed. Shall call his name Jesus, Emmanuel, because he shall save his people from sins. Hello, the ministry of angels. See, in the life of Jesus, the grace of Jesus wouldn't have operated fully without the ministry of angels. The Bible says, when Jesus was driven in the might of the Spirit to the wilderness, where he defeated the tempter, angels came to minister to him. Hello, yes. The ministry of the angels did not end. We found out that even at the resurrection of Jesus, angels were at the tomb to point the first responders to the resurrection that had happened. My God, why are you searching for the living amongst the dead? Jesus is no longer in the tomb. Jesus is alive. That's exactly what we are saying. We will give a witness that Jesus is alive. The early church did it was by the ministry of the angels. Do you remember the angel that came to meet, that directed the church? Paul. Angel that stepped into the prison, Paul and Silas. Do you remember angelic manifestation that gave them direction? Angels came and said, we need you. Your ministry is needed in Macedonia. Do you remember? Do you people understand what I'm saying? Yes. Do you people understand? Do you people remember when angel communicated the revelation of Jesus? The letters to the angels of the churches, the seven churches, the ministry of the angels, we can't do without them even this end time. There's an angel that is sent to communicate the gospel. When I found it, I said, yes, this is what wise believers that know the times and the seasons. Ah, my God. God is raising many categories of people in the church. Do you understand what I'm saying? And these people are not Christians. He's raising men of war. He's raising men of understanding that know what the church should do. And he's raising men of provision. Now I'm talking about the men of understanding. Incredible men that know the
you'll
time
come to pick that Bible
that we are in. Men of understanding, incredible things that we are doing here, but we will keep it because this thing is going out for the nations. The nations will hear this thing. It's happening here. The gospel of the kingdom is being preached. Let's look at Revelation 14. There was something that I saw that hit me. When it hit me, I said, hey, we need to tap into the ministry of this particular angel. It's not just an ordinary angel. The angel has the cachet, the body of light for the gospel of the kingdom that the world will hear. Revelation chapter 14. The first started about Jesus and his 144,000. I'm going to start from right from here. And I saw another angel fly in the midst of heaven, having the everlasting gospel to preach unto them that dwell on earth, and to every nation and kindred and tongue and people, saying with a loud voice, fear God. This is what we have lost today, the fear of God. One of the spirits, seven spirits. Yes. And give glory to him, for the hour of his judgment is come. And worship him that made heaven and earth and sea and the fountains of waters. That was the message. But you see, this angel had the everlasting gospel. You understand what I'm saying? See, nobody received revelation by itself without an angel revealing it. There is no message that God gives to man that angel doesn't open inside man's spirit. We have thrown away the ministry of angels. When they are standing waiting for Jesus to command them to come and send us message, we are here running after our own affairs. We have frustrated the angels. Today's church, I'm talking about today's Christian practicing church. We don't know the ministry of the angels anymore. And this angel is not just an ordinary angel. This particular Revelation 14 angel is at a particular providence in time, particular time and season and dispensation and year, particular day in the year of the Lord's favor, that God sent these angels to the church. Hello, do you remember one of the signs that will mark the second coming of Jesus? Jesus gave it in Matthew chapter 24, verse 14. He said, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached. He's telling you that an angel that has the gospel that will be preached. That means it's the angel that will oversee the preaching of the gospel that God is releasing. That's what it means. You will do well as the church that has wisdom to cash into the dimension of that angelic frequency. There's an angelic frequency that we should deal with. That's why we need the ministry of prophets in the church. That's why the foundation of the church is apostles and prophets. We need people that will delve into the supernatural and bring messages. Not messages about your money. Not messages about your health. Not messages about deliverance, breakthrough. No, messages about the agenda of God for the nations. Hello, hello. How would we have known that the eclipse yesterday was an engagement ring? It wasn't just another eclipse that happened. Some people, because of angelic ministration, told them that Jesus is coming for his church. And no man wants to marry an immature girl. Who is an immature girl? They call them slave queens, Abby. That's what we call them today. That's just a reflection of the state of the church. They are called slave queens. Can you open the door? Let's throw some lights inside here. They are called slave queens. All of them, their own is what they will eat. That's the way we are today's church. What will we eat? What will we dress? Let us look good. Even when the master said we should not concern ourselves with what all these things, like the normal people, don't go by the way of the Gentiles. What we want now, we don't want to take responsibility. We don't want to stand in the place as Zion, the light of the world. We have rejected the assignment that the man gave us. The gospel, we don't even understand again. We are not even talking about the government of Jesus. We are not talking about the territories of the earth. Even when we can read in scripture that the kingdoms of this world has become the kingdom of our God and of his dear son. Even when Jesus has taught us to pray and he said, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name, thy kingdom come, that will be done on the earth as it is in heaven. We have thrown away the responsibility to make sure that this earth is preserved as the salt of the earth, the light of the world. All of us are okay with our Christian identity. I'm a Christian, that's all. When I die, I'll go to heaven. Which heaven when you have not done the work that you're supposed to do on earth? Which heaven when you have not preached the gospel? Which heaven are you going to? When you are not reigned as a king on earth, which heaven are you going to? When the devil has messed up this world that you are living in, and you are living in, they haven't come to even mess you up, and you people are taking it like that? How? How? How did it happen like this? What happened to the church? What happened to the church? But listen, there is a way out. There's a way out. The way out is in the revelation of Jesus. I found the solution. The revelation of the Jesus. The Jesus that comes to establish his government on earth. We must reveal that Jesus. It's not the time to be a Christian. It's not the time to practice Christianity and make it just another religion. And all you stand for is what you want to line your pockets with. What you want to live the good life on earth with. What you want to be established on earth as one of another rich Dangote. No. It's not enough to practice that religion. That religion has not shown us to Jesus. The religion has not taken us up to Jesus. There is a government plan in God's mind, especially when the government of the world is failing. Hello. There is a media plan in God's mind for this show. Especially when you turn on your news, all you hear is one level of destruction to another. Hello. There is an economic plan from the realms of the spirit. It's for man. It's for the earth. Hello. I'm talking about the government of Jesus, especially when money is failing and falling. Yes. There is a new plan for entertainment, especially when the devil has sat down in this mountain and is influencing the whole. Our generation is influencing us with ideas that we don't even understand about family. There is a new plan. I'm telling you about the government. Look at the government that we are having. Look at our education. Jesus said that we teach your children and great shall be their peace and prosperity. So where is this plan? When are we going to come out with this plan? When are we going to take responsibility for the things that God has put in our hands? He said, see this day, I put my word in your mouth. I've set you as king above the nations. We are ambassadors of Christ, for crying out loud. Ambassador is not a religious office. Ambassador is a political office. Who is promoting the politics of God? Who is promoting the agenda of God in the world? Where are they? Where are they that will stand and say, okay, I'm the David now. You have kept the nations down for too long. You will not keep us down anymore. Where is the person that will stand and be the mountain of the Lord's house? That Isaiah 2:3 talks about. He said, it shall come to pass. This is my joy afterwards. It shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the Lord's house will be established at the tops of the mountains. He said, all nations will flow into it. They will say, come, teach us your ways. They didn't say, come, take us to your churches. Exactly. They didn't say, come, take us to where you are gathering and teach us how to make the money that you make. No. They said, teach us your ways. The same ways that God showed to Moses is the same ways that the people will ask us to teach them. My God. The Bible says, out of Zion shall go forth the law. That means the law that will govern the conduct of men will come out of the church. I'm talking about a mature church. I'm talking about a church that is ready for a bride. For a groom. I'm talking about the church of Jesus Christ. I'm talking about the ecclesia. Hey, especially when families are the way they are. Man is marrying man now in your world, and you people are saying, you're clapping your hand. For which God are you praising to in a strange land? Even in your churches, man is marrying man now. They are giving men out to men. And that's the generation that you lead your children for. Where is the God? That his covenant is from generation to generation. Where is your God, church? We ought to manifest Jesus. It's Jesus. We must manifest Jesus. The time has come for the manifestation of the sons of God. Those that are led by the Spirit of God. Because Jesus is coming for a church without spot and wrinkles. He's looking for the trees of righteousness. People that will identify themselves as the trees of righteousness. The plantings of God. The ones that will stand on the watch and cast the devil out wherever they meet the devil. Hello, I'm talking about the church, the real church that will make it at the end, the real church, the real church that will reign with Jesus, the ones that will reign as kings and priests of the earth. Who is the king? The Bible says the law, the word of the king is law. That's the king. Whatever he says happens, whether the devil likes it or not. Who is the priest? The ones that stand as an intercessor for the nations. See, God has given the church incredible dimension of authority. The influence that we are playing with, I don't understand. I don't understand why we are playing with the influence that the Father has given us. He gave us his word. He gave us his faith. He gave us his grace. He gave us his message. My God. He gave us his gifts. It's the gift of Jesus Christ. Everything. Look at all the investment that we are playing with.
That's a big U-turn.
Look at the investment that we are playing with. If we are still happy with this thing, it is time for us to mourn. Because when we begin the mourning, we are begging God to continue his ministry. Because the ministry of Jesus continues with the mourning of the church. We must mourn. Let's go to Isaiah 61. I'll end it there so that we will not turn this place into another place. Let me end it there. Isaiah 61. When Jesus came to give his method statement, that's what he said there. The Spirit of the Lord is upon me because the Lord has anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of prison doors to them that are bound, to proclaim the acceptable year of the Lord's labor and the day of vengeance of our God. He said to comfort all that mourn. Hello, it's time to mourn. Are you hearing me? To appoint unto them that mourn in Zion. I thought the Bible said, upon Mount Zion there shall be deliverance, and the house of Jacob shall possess their possession. But he's saying that to them that mourn in Zion, they are crying in Zion like somebody died. That's what mourning is. What did he say he would do to them? To give unto them beauty for ashes. The oil of joy. That means there's many revelations coming for these people for mourning. Because the Bible says, with joy shall you draw from the wells of your salvation. That means the light coming. The light is the rock that will smash this system. We're inside the system, but we don't know.
Yes.
The people that said that our Oga has been in seat for 20 years, that he should live there, those are the owners of the system. We are inside their system. And we are comfortable in the name of Jesus still. That's why this morning we must activate this morning. What I'm doing now, I said it should be in record so that people will hear.
Yes.
Who will believe when nobody has preached? Who will hear when nobody has preached? Who will believe when we have not given ourselves opportunity to hear? We need to mourn. The garment of praise for the spirit of heaviness, that they might be called, not Christians, they might be called trees of righteousness. That means because of these people, God, we have hope that righteousness will spring forth out of the earth, that the earth will be covered with the knowledge of the glory of God as the waters cover the sea. Just because of church, he calls them trees of righteousness. That's their name, trees of righteousness. The planting, one planting of God, that he might be glorified. I want you to come and see work. He didn't tell you anything other than what you will see. You will see it inside scripture. He said, and they shall build the old wastes, and they shall raise up the former desolations, and they shall repair waste cities. You see work? They will repair waste cities. Can you see it? And the desolations of many generations. That's political work. That's government work. That's work that government has not been able to do. God is waiting for the church. If we can stop looking at ourselves and what we want to line our pocket with and begin to lead for the kingdom of God, the government of God established on earth, the reign of Jesus established on earth, there's so much that we will achieve. There's so much that we will achieve that we have thrown away because we hid our talent in the earth. We hid the talent in the earth. We hid the talent in our flesh. We hid the talent to satisfy ourselves. Hello? Self should die in the church.
Yes.
When self dies, the church becomes mature. When self dies, lust dies. When lust dies, pride dies. When self dies, lust of the eyes, lust of the flesh, all of them will die. And what is formed that may increase
and will decrease
and die.
Decrease.
The increase of Jesus. My God. That's what the devil is afraid of. The increase of Jesus. What do you want to make us learn? The mindset of Jesus. The sensitivity of Jesus. The awareness of Jesus. The authority of Jesus. The compassion of Jesus. The passion of Jesus. The zeal of Jesus. The love of Jesus. What will make us learn that? Is the same thing that will make the devil pack his load and get out of this earth. Yes, I don't think I'll calm down until I see that the church has woken up. Mm-hmm. Because I believe that God has called me for this office. Yes, to be the voice that will prepare the highway for God in the hearts of people. Every mountain will be leveled, every valley will be filled. The crooked paths that we're looking at today will be made straight, and the rough places will be made a plain surface. Why? Because it's time for Jesus to be glorified in his church. When we say be glorified in the heavens, be glorified in this earth, I like to say be glorified in this temple, Jesus.
Jesus, be thou glorified.
That's what we're saying. Let Jesus just take all the glory. Let him take all the glory. Let them just see that when I step into the room, they don't see me anymore. They don't see a Christian anymore. They see Jesus. Exactly. Let the world see Jesus. We can pray. It can just become a prayer meeting now. In fact, it's a prayer meeting. How many of us here? We are seven of us here. We can stand for the seven mountains and just start doing something, because I don't believe the steps of the righteous is just yaga yaga waka that we did. Everybody that came in here came in for a reason. We are supposed to just pray for these seven places that the devil has used to influence this world. The media, education, the government, entertainment, the religion that we are practicing today. Listen, economy of nations, even in our basic families. Let's just ask that let his will be done in all this. In all these portals, because they are portals that opens man to the realms of the spirit. Let God say, Father, let God raise people, because the harvest is plentiful, the laborers are few. Let him raise people that will step into this battleground and come and win this battle. His kingdom conquest we're talking about. Is thy kingdom come that we're talking about? Yes. We can pray in other tongues. We can pray in our understanding. We can pray in the spirit just as much as we want to do. Let's ask that God should have his way on earth. Let him have his way on earth. Let him have his way in the nations of this world. Let him have his way in this world. Let him have his way. In the name of Jesus, have your way in the media. Have your way in education. Have your way in the government. In the name of Jesus. Have your way in these nations. In the name of Jesus, we submit the nations to your hand. We submit the nations to your hand. Lord, we stand and we say, restore. We call, we cry for a restoration. We cry for a revival. In the name of Jesus, let your will be done. In the name of Jesus, let your will be done. Let your will be done. Holy Father, let your will be done. Let your will be done.
Let your will be done in our nations, O God, in our schools, in our governments, in our homes, in our families, O God, in our homes, in our families, O God, in our churches, O God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen. And the Bible says that the earth is wailing, is groaning, is waiting for the manifestation of the sons of God. The world is waiting for people that have been led by the Spirit. The world is waiting for people that have the fear of God, and they keep the commandments of God, and they have for themselves the testimony of Jesus. The people that have the testimony of Jesus, they are the people that are called the trees of righteousness. They are the people that are called the Ecclesia, the Church of Jesus Christ, the light of the world, the salt of the earth. It's not the light of themselves. It's not the salt of themselves. Listen, it's the light of the world, the city with systems and institutions that set upon the hills that cannot be hidden. Let's pray for the rise of the church in the glory of God. The church that reveals Jesus.
Jesus. That's what we are praying, Father, in the name of Jesus.
The church
that manifest, oh God, Jesus, that will reveal Jesus to the world. The church that will reveal Jesus to the world in America. The church that will reveal church. The church that will reveal Jesus in the dying world in the name of Jesus. The church, God Almighty, that will reveal Jesus in a dying nation, in a dying world, in a dying family. Father, reveal your church. Revive us, church. Revive your church, God Almighty. Father, revive your church. Let there be light in the world. Let your light shine again, Father. Let us your church take its rightful position on the earth. In the name of Jesus, Father, cause your light, oh God, to shine. Oh God, Almighty, let your church go. Light, oh God, is in the rightful position, oh God, in the world. The church that will reveal Jesus Christ to the nations. The church that will reveal Jesus Christ to the end of the earth, oh God.
Thank you. Thank you, because you did not mean what when you said, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached. You didn't say has been preached, you said shall be. That means that's an expectation you have for the end time nations. The gospel, this gospel, the specific one that you preached, shall be preached. Yes, in all the world, for a witness to the nations. Yes, that's the message that will bring an end. Yes, the power to preach the gospel. We receive it today.
Amen.
The power to preach the gospel, the grace that is sufficient to receive this message, to understand this message, to receive this revelation, so that we'll be able to establish your kingdom on earth. We'll be able to align with the Holy Spirit and establish your kingdom on earth. We receive it today for the church.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Now Jesus is breaking out of us. Yes. The capacity to manifest Jesus is what is coming out of us.
Amen.
The devil doesn't have any hold anymore over our souls. Yes. Because there is nothing of the devil that is in us. We are partakers of his divine nature. It's the blood of Jesus that flows in us. It is the life of Jesus that is attached to us. It's the anointing of Jesus that we carry. Yes. The power to manifest Jesus. Thank you, because supermen are rising out of the church. Heroes, the Bible says, and saviors shall rise up. Obadiah 21. That's what it says. Saviors shall rise up out of Zion, and they shall reign on the mountains of Israel. Yes. Thank you, Holy Spirit. We glorify. We just worship you today. We lift these hands in worship. Thank you. You have started something good. We continue. The nations of the earth, they experience you. The world will know that you are God. You are still alive. But it is one of your people. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Father. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we prophesy.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yes. Yes. Thank you.